I am a dirty, filthy fur wearer. I am a teen Cruella de Vil, and I've gotta pay!
Tiny Todd's guest, let's all wish her well on her trip to Washington next week, where she'll be honored as Student Activist of the Year. All right, now we have time for one final question before nap time.
Lily, what are the qualifications to become a badass animal rights lady like yourself?
Thanks for asking, Keisha. Just be very tough and obnoxiously strident. That is the only way to make it as an activist. Take, for example, my work with Echo Lobster Relief. It all began one afternoon a year ago when I was blinded by a heinous injustice. I had stopped by a restaurant called Croutons to suggest a savory alternative.
One want. He got the bum right claw. This lobster is a gimp.
How much to buy him and set him free in his natural main waters?
For you, girl with hair the color of mud, $5,000.
What? That's highway robbery.
Lobster gimp drain money from Caesar Croutons. I built the aquarium. I paid for the lobster poop filter. And all for what? The star of my seafood buffet is a washout. You want? You pay what I paid. Good day, mud hair.
Don't worry, little Eddie. I will set you free.
Lobsters have claws and a tough shell. Tougher than my grandmama's elbows. Can't they fend for themselves?
Well, you know, kids, it's funny how sometimes creatures with the hardest exteriors have the softest insides. Lobsters are like that. Inside their tough shell is a nervous system 10 times as sensitive as a human being's. When lobsters are cruelly boiled alive, their supersonic screams of pain are so gut-wrenching that dogs within a one-mile radius will often begin whimpering.
Lord, will it already be boiled alive?
I am proud to say no. I have purchased little Eddie and will be going to Croutons.
In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? 'Cause baby, you've been deceived.
Well, me.
Well, my biolings, as always, this year's crop of term papers on my fave topic, natural selection, has brought a tear to my eye. First, I cried because after reading most of your numbing prose, it was obvious we need to have a bake sale so this school's special ed program can be expanded. Then I came upon a report so miraculous, it turned my tears of sorrow into joyous sailing. Ms. McQueen, impressive as always. As you know, I'm a fan of leather. Congrats.
Thank you.
Oh, and age single-space diatribe entitled Mary Cherry Must Die, while amusing, just gets you a big old case of the flunks. Cherry, get off that phone! Everybody else, eyes on my handout on the origin of blackheads!
Well, guess who that was, Lil Lily?
Shut up.
Caesar Croutons himself. He's got a new lobster coming in today. Its destination, my gullet!
You wouldn't dare, Mary Cherry.
There's not a crustacean safe in this state from our retribution-seeking mandibles. Lil Eddie's successor, his sister, Lil Babe, is mine. And soon she too will be swimming in my potent stomach acid. In short, Lil Lily, eat me!
Believe me, if I wasn't a vegetarian, Mary Cherry, I would.
Wait, you are admitting to me that the only reason Brooke got a higher grade on our natural selection reports is because her paper was packaged better.
Are you taping me?
No.
In that case, yes, I admit it.
That's what I suspected. That is not
fair. Miss McPherson, let's review the definition of natural selection,
Natural selection is about survival of the fittest.
No, it's about survival of the prettiest, and Miss McQueen's presentation fit right into that theory. At one point, I sat on her leather-encased report and pretended I was driving a Lexus.
Miss Glass, I worked for 2 weeks on that paper. I needed an A to raise my GPA, and I know my paper was good.
Don't get tough with me, miss. That's not how we survive in bio. Incidentally, how about those highlights of Miss McQueen's, Stunning. While we're on the topic of hair, Miss McRat's Nest, may I tell you that the messy braids and the drab coffee color you've been sporting on your noggin this year not only detract from your looks, but might force me to knock your current B grade down to a C.
That is just wrong.
No, that's natural selection.
Principal Hall, you wanted to see me?
Oh, yes. Come in, Harrison. Meet Kennedy High's new foreign exchange student, Exquisite Wu. Exquisite, this is Harrison John.
Until I was 4. He ran a Radio Shack there.
Harrison, I need a translator. Somebody to take her and introduce her to our students and to help her adapt to our craven American culture. Are you game?
What's that mean?
Gao Qingchu, Xiao Bailian. 你不是我的类型.